Hello, everyone. Welcome to a new episode of Ace Attorney Justice for All. I'm your host, Kaylee Watari, and today we are going to start case three, the next case in the game, which is Turnabout Big Tov, which is a case that I do not like. Anyway, we're going to start with the intro and part one investigation. Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, welcome to the show. Prepare to witness a man who has mastered the wonder of flight. The world's greatest magician! The one, the only, Maximilian Galactica! December 26, 8:12 p.m. Barry Big Circus, Circus Entrance. Entrance. Oh dear, what happened here? Wow, that was like living a dream! I haven't even caught my breath yet! That was amazing, wasn't it, Pearly? It was great! There was a dancing bear! And a tiger that jumped through a ring of fire. An elephant who rode a giant ball. Not to mention that guy who flew through the air. Yeah, Max Galactica? He was absolutely fabulous. Huh? What? Max? Max Galactica, the world's greatest magician. A magician? No, magician. Mr. Nick? What is it, Pearls? Does magic have anything to do with channeling spirits? I don't think it has anything to do with channeling. You don't know about magic, do you, Pearls? I'm sorry. Poor little Pearls. I braved the winter cold and took Pearls to see the circus. It's been 6 months since the incident in Karine Village. It was during that terrible time that I met Pearls. Excuse me. It seems like she's starting to get back to normal. It's time to go. You're right. We can't miss the last train. Pearls, you remembered the train? Of course I did! But I don't really understand what everyone means by express train. Well, Nick, see you later. I'll come by to help clean the office. It's gotta be spotless for the new year. Don't worry about it, really. You're going to visit Mr. Nick on New Year's? Maybe. I'm glad you will get to spend your New Year's with your special someone. It's time to go. Happy New Year, Mr. Nick! Happy New Year, indeed. I really hope it will turn out that way. It won't. December 28th, 9:12 a.m. Writing call law offices. Well, today wraps it up for this year. I hope I can finish cleaning this place up in one day. Steel Samurai ringtone. Beep. Hello, this is Phoenix. Nick, it's terrible! Maya, perfect timing. Things are terrible here, too. Huh? The office is a terrible mess, and I have to clean it up. What are you talking about, Nick? My dirty office? What are you talking about? Listen, Nick, you have to turn on the TV. Now, let's check in at the scene. Huh? What happened? Thank you, we're here at the Very Big Circus. The Very Big Circus has become the center of a sensational murder. The scene has created quite a stir among the throngs of excited onlookers. The Very Big Circus? That's the circus we went to, right? They're saying that there was a murder? Yeah, they arrested him too. Arrested who? Max! They arrested Max Galactica. Maximilian Galactica? A flying man, a popular magician who can fly through the sky. Maya says she was a huge fan of Max. Sorry, it was a little fast for me to read. Alright, Nick, I'll see you in 2 hours at the detention center. What? See you there. You still got plenty of time to clean up your office later. What? Oh, Maya. Turning down my volume a little. It's a little loud. There. Okay, we will move to the detention center, folks. December 28th, 11:19 a.m., detention center visitor's room. What are they talking about? Why did they arrest Max? You're asking the wrong man on that one, Maya. Maybe he used his magical skills to deal death with a sleight of hand. Maximilian Galactica would never do such a thing! Fabulous! What the young lady just said was absolutely fabulous! What a clever girl! Such a fabulous understanding of events! What's with all this fabulous talk? Welcome to the visitor's room! It's Max, Nick! Look, it's the real Maximilian Galactica! Alright, sweetie, pick a card! Any card! He called me sweetie? Nick! Time's running out, sweetie! Pick a card! Any card! This one. I thought you would pick that one, sweetie! The Ace of Hearts! He got it! He caught it, Nick! Look, he got it! What can I say, sweetie? You've stolen one of my most valued possessions! One of Maximilian Galactica's hearts! Max! Oh, Max! All time to make this an absolutely fabulous time! Max, you should let Nick pick a card. I don't want to pick one of his hearts and steal it. And you are? Whoa! How silly of me! You must be Sweetie's driver. Her driver? Whatever, hurry up and pick a card. Any card. I want this one. So, Sweetie, let's be honest here. You came to this visitor's room to visit me, didn't you? Yes, I'm your biggest fan. Fabulous, absolutely fabulous, thank you so much. Hey, what about my card? Think of it as a souvenir. Well, Nick, I think it's time to get to work. What's the matter, Nick? Why are you looking at the ceiling? I was just thinking about what I should have for lunch. Kitty, drop Porcupine Head over there. Shower me with your attention, okay? Yes! Absolutely fabulous! Absolutely cringe-inducing. Time to talk to the crazy guy. Well, he's not crazy, he's just a performer. Max Galactica. Max, I was hoping you could tell me a little bit more about yourself. Fabulous! I think we should get to know each other better, too. Why don't you come sit next to me? There's a big piece of security glass between us. Oh, sweet Jesus, what in the world? If only I could use magic, then I could make this wall disappear! What is this guy talking about? Anyways, lately you've become awfully famous, haven't you, Max? Let's Maximilian to you, Porcupine Head! Get it straight! Jeez, people nowadays, they get their panties all in a bunch or nothing. Anyway, Maximilian, you won a very prestigious award recently, did you not? I did indeed, it was fabulous! I won the Magician's Grand Prix, held by the Association of International Magicians! It's an award that recognizes that I'm the most fabulous of fabulous world magicians! There was a trophy and a bust. It was an amazing day. Wow, that's incredible. Isn't it? I'm certifiably the greatest magician in the world. I'm going to guess he didn't win a trophy for most modest magician. Very big circus. You were signed to an exclusive contract with the Very Big Circus, correct? That's the long and short of it. You sure do your research, sweetie. I'm impressed. You just can't watch a magician on TV, you know. Magic is so fabulous, you have to see it with your own eyes, sweetie. You're right. You're so right. However, the circus, it's a dinosaur. A thing of the past. Nowadays, no one even cares about what goes on there. Huh? What do you mean? That's why I signed the contract. That's why you signed the contract? Thanks to me, the Very Big Circus is fabulously popular. People come out in droves to catch a glimpse of the magic of Max Galactica. I revived the dinosaur that is the circus. But to me, it was just another magic trick. Isn't it just wonderful, sweetie? Yes! I made all the old crusty circus performers obsolete. But I kind of like the circus performances. Mile looks a bit down. What happened? To the meat of it, shall we? Tell me what happened at the Very Big Circus.
Last night, the ringmaster was murdered.
The ringmaster? You mean Russell Berry?
Someone smashed him over the head, I hear. He was slumped over on the ground. Even though it was the middle of the night, the police presence was fabulous. The police questioned me at length.
Questioned you about what?
About everything. I was the last one to see the ringmaster before he was murdered. I saw him that night, in his room.
So then, why were you arrested?
Arrested? Don't make an anthill into a mountain, sweetie. They just wanted to consult with me on matters, that's all.
Nick? I don't think Max understands how serious this is. She's right. I think I should shock him back to reality. Meeting with Russell. The Before the murder, you met with the Grandmaster?
Uh-huh.
What did you talk about?
Things that aren't for your ears.
Maya, would you please ask him?
What did you talk about with the Ringmaster, Max?
It was nothing. Small talk, really. We were just having a chat about my salary.
Salary?
I am the one bringing in all of the crowds to the circus. I think that I should be compensated as such. You agree, don't you?
Yes.
That's all you talked about? Of course it was! A fabulous chat!
Oh, Cyclops, guys. First ones of the case.
Fabulous. Why does he have to keep saying fabulous?
What's the matter, Nick? You look all bent out of shape.
Well, there's no way I can break those yet.
But he hasn't hired us, so... maybe if I show him my attorney's badge?
What is that badge? Is it used in a disappearing act?
I'm not a magician, Max. I'm an attorney.
An attorney? Then why are you wasting your time talking to me?
He isn't wasting his time, Max. You're...
Okay, relax, sweetie. Just a little overanxious, I think.
Nick?
Anyways, I've been curious about something for a while now.
What's that?
Why do you keep looking at me with such a sad look on your face, sweetie?
Because you've been arrested for murder.
Oh, don't be ignorant. They wouldn't arrest someone like me.
Why is that?
Obviously, because I'm the fabulous Maximilian Galactica.
So?
I'm the very big star of the very big circus.
And that means... what exactly?
I'm rich, I'm paid fabulous sums.
Which means what?
Max? Quit joking around! You've got to be pulling my magic wand! The police aren't really serious about all this, are they?
They don't arrest people as a joke.
Oh, look at Max, he's crushed.
Well, you need to wake up and smell the coffee. This is serious business, after all. Yes?
Porky, I mean, sir, you're a lawyer, right?
Uh-oh, yeah, I'm an attorney.
Please help me, I didn't kill nobody.
Didn't kill nobody?
I may be more spoiled than a hog and a hamburger and mud pie. But a killer? That's insane! I could never...
Max?
I swear! I just wanted to pay off my daddy's debt! He's back at the farm!
Okay, I'll take your case.
Really?
Really.
Oh, thank you much! You'll sure are nice folks!
Max?
Yes?
What's your real name?
It's Billy Bob Johns.
What? What's the matter, Maya?
He's really just a country bumpkin?
Yes, he is, Maya. Yes, he is.
I must apologize for not being my absolutely fabulous self just now, sweetie.
Huh?
Mr. Attorney?
Yes?
A few minutes ago, you took one of my cards, didn't you?
Now that he mentions it, I did take a card.
It was the Ten of Hearts, right?
What? How'd he... He got it right again.
What can I say, you two? You've stolen some of my most valued possessions. 10 of Maximilian Galactica's hearts. You sure do have a lot of hearts, don't you? I'm putting my faith in you, sweetie. He didn't just call me sweetie, did he? Alright, let's make this an absolutely fabulous case. Come on, Nick. Alright, now we can move along. Let's go to the crime scene, shall we? Circus entrance. December 28th, very big circus entrance. We're here again. Yep, but this time we are here for work. It hasn't been that long since the crime, so the police are likely still on the scene. Let's find someone who might know something about what happened. Sounds like a plan, Maya. Moving along, let's start with the... we'll go to the lodging plus plaza, that's where it happened, I think. Lodging house plaza. This seems to be a dorm where all the performers in the circus stay. Really? So... that stoogie clown should be here, huh? He's so kooky. Oh, it's you two. Oh, Detective Gumshoe. I always see you hanging around when I'm working a crime scene, pal. You always seem to be working so hard, Detective. I'd rather not be working hard, but with crime you don't make your own hours. If I had to be at the circus anyways, I want to see the lion tamer and the tightrope. However, no matter where I go, the show is always the same. Dead body, stage left. Nick, he's complaining. That's a rarity. Let's get back to business now, okay? And business is talking to the good detective. Do you know who will be the prosecutor in court tomorrow? Of course. It will be Miss Von Karma again, pal. She isn't gonna hit me with her whip again, is she? What do you have to worry about? You only have to see her in court. When she shows up at the precinct, the sound of that whip never ends, pal. Detective Gumshoe? That's enough about Von Karma. What about that guy? What is he up to? That guy? Sorry, dropped my phone card. What happened to Edgeworth? You know, the Edgeworth that's Nick's rival? What in the world happened when I went back home? Mr. Edgeworth, you haven't heard what happened to him? Nick won't tell me. Well, to be honest, I'm not at liberty to tell you either. Let's just say he's not around anymore.
He's not around? Nick, what does he mean Mr. Edgeworth isn't around?
Exactly what he said. He's not around, Maya. Edgeworth is gone. Don't say his name again, okay?
Nick?
We'll find out about Edgeworth in the next case. What happened? The ringmaster of the circus was murdered, wasn't he? Yep. Last night around 10 p.m., pal. He died outside in the cold. A pretty sad way to go, if you ask me, pal.
It was rather cold.
This is the scene of the crime, pal. The body was found right over there. What about where you are standing now? Surprised you, didn't I?
I'm not laughing.
Excuse me, but do you mind telling me what happened to the victim? He was killed by a blow to the noggin, pal.
heap!
It's pretty clear-cut as far as murders go. He was discovered quickly.
But?
There's just one thing that doesn't quite fit.
There always seems to be something that doesn't quite fit.
Something unusual.
What was this one thing that just didn't quite fit? The thing you mentioned earlier.
Footprints, pal. Footprints.
Footprints?
Look at this picture of the crime scene.
And what's this?
This wooden box under the body? No clue, pal. Some forensics experts took it back and are examining it now.
And what is so mysterious about the footprints?
Whoa, calm down now. Take a good look at the footprints in this picture.
The victim's footprints are on the scene.
That's right, pal. The problem is...
Killer's footprints aren't there!
Bingo! Where did the killer come from and where did the killer run off to? Obviously, there is no way the killer committed this crime of flying.
A flying criminal? That's when something just clicked in my head. Barry. Big Top and Max.
There's no way! Flying is impossible!
That's right. Flying is impossible. Absolutely impossible.
What's with the whole laugh, pal?
I meant nothing by it, pal.
Better stated, I meant I don't want to talk about it.
Maybe I can get some info about Max out of him. Crime photo added to the record. Alright, well, to get info about Max, let us try. Max's profile.
It looks like Max is the most unpopular guy in the circus tent. You know what they say, a bad attitude follows you everywhere.
He's a bit arrogant, but he didn't seem that bad. But just because someone has a bad attitude doesn't make them a criminal.
It's not just his attitude. I've got proof, pal.
Huh?
He left something at the scene of the crime. One of his magician's trademarks. An incredibly well-made silk hat.
Well, it does have very classy decorative elements. Silk hat added to the record.
Max uses a cloak, silk hat, and white roses as his signature symbols.
Pretty mundane, aren't they? Who cares if they are mundane? At least they are easy to understand.
I must have hit a nerve. That's what he said.
Who said?
The eyewitness.
Huh?
Tell us about the eyewitness.
Well, that's our fourth topic unlock. Yay! Eyewitness. How about any eyewitnesses?
You know I'm not going to tell you that, pal. That's the prosecution's trump card. Oh, I just remembered.
What?
I forgot to mention that you two are barred from entering that lodging house.
Why is that?
Oh, no reason, just something I remembered to tell you.
It must be because there's an eyewitness inside that lodging house. Let's check it out.
Oh no, you don't, pal!
And how do you intend on stopping us? Let's just walk right inside that, to Mo's room. Oh, I hate Mo. Let's see if I can do him. Lodging hall, first floor, Mo's room. This is it. The name tag on the door says Mo on it. I guess he's not here. Wow, it's a real mess in here. My room's probably worse, though. Oh well, I give up. We'll have to come back later. He's not here. Okay then. And I don't think there's anything I need to look at in there. Probably be able to come back here after the big top. I think I came over to this area early, probably. So let's go to the big top area. There we go. Very big circus, big top. The circus stage sure doesn't look this small from out in the audience. Wow! This is where they all perform, isn't it? Nick, do some somersaults! I'm not doing any somersaults, Maya. Why not? You look like you'd be great at it. Why do I look like I'd be great at somersaults? Nick? It wasn't me. Tiger! He's coming this way. Oh dear. Nick, you're too young to die, Nick! Stay, heal! I'm still here. I'm not dead yet. Nick, are you okay? Scared you, didn't I? Regent is such a cute tiger, isn't he? What's the matter? You two sure are quiet. Don't what's the matter, me? Nick, he almost died there. He wasn't anywhere close to getting hurt, let alone dying. This little tiger hardly ever bites people. And besides, people normally never get to play with a wild tiger, right? So if you think about it, you're actually really lucky. Uh-huh. You agree, don't you? I guess. What do you mean, you guess? Why are you agreeing with her? Woohoo! Your costume! It's cute! I want to try it on! Costume? You mean my clothes? You don't mind letting me try it on, right? I guess not. Really? You're the best! Wow, the tables turned quickly on that one. So much for the tiger thing. Oh, I forgot to introduce myself. I'm Regina Berry, the renowned animal tamer of the Berry Big Circus. My name's Maya Fay. I'm a spear medium. Phoenix Wright, attorney of law. When you put us up next to an animal tamer, I bet we really look odd. Nice to meet ya! Likewise? What happened? Hey, Regina, what do you know about what happened last night? You mean the murder? My dad was murdered? I can't imagine how hard this must be for you. That was insensitive. That's right, the ringmaster was your... Yep, the ringmaster was my dad. I'm so sorry about what happened to him. Why do you say you're sorry?
Huh?
Anyways, everyone was here practicing last night.
Even your dad?
Yes, everyone was here. We finished up around 10 p.m. After that, everyone went off on their own. I was the only one who stayed around here.
Why did you do that?
I was playing with Regent.
Regent? That... She means... She was with that beast?
That's when the police showed up when they took me to check things out. Dad was dead.
For someone whose father was just murdered, she seems awfully perky. I wish she would tell us more about her dad.
Regina. That's incredible that you were an animal tamer. If you say so.
It has to be really scary.
Scary? Why?
Huh?
Regent isn't scary, he's cute. Ever since Leon died, Regent has been my best friend.
Leon?
Yes, Leon the lion.
Leon the lion? Regent and Regina. Interesting name choices.
Leon, he died? Yes, actually, he was killed. My dad killed him.
What?
Why did he do that? I'm not sure why he did it.
It's tough not to get charmed when she looks at you with those innocent eyes.
There should be more to ask her, so let's try presenting something. Maybe her dad's profile. There we go. Russell Berry.
After practice was over, Dad went right back to his room.
His room?
Yes. That door right over there leads to the ringmaster's room. I don't know why, but he went off to his room in a hurry. I wonder what happened.
The ringmaster's room.
It's probably a good idea to check it out for myself.
There we go. Any other lines of topic? Not yet. So let's move along. Ringmaster's room.
Big Top Ringmaster's room.
This was the Ringmaster's room.
Yes, this room belonged to the victim.
Which means this must be where Max met the Ringmaster last night.
Now that you mention it, that is what he said.
I wonder what... that's an interesting poster.
Ah! It's a poster of Max!
I want it, Nick! I want it!
I want to get out of here.
So this is the first area where we can examine, I believe. There should be a few things to look at. Number one, let's look at this coat.
You may not know this, but they call this a tailcoat.
And they call this the face of someone who already knew that.
What?
A scrap of white paper is sticking out of the coat pocket.
Huh? Where?
Calm down, Maya. You can't just go rummaging through people's coats.
You always make me feel like I'm doing something wrong.
I thought we were gonna get the paper. Okay, maybe one of the posters?
There's a lot of posters here, don't you think?
There are indeed.
So many posters that they aren't likely to miss one, are they?
Maya, we're supposed to be the honest ones around here.
But you didn't even notice that I took one.
She already swiped one. incorrigible, you know that?
Max's promo poster added to the record.
Now is that all we can get? Now let's look at this.
It's a table for guests. There are some papers scattered on top.
Ah, look at this! Max's salary is written on this piece of paper. Yikes!
What is it?
I didn't know that's a magician. Salary is incredible!
She looks like she's about ready to pass out from shock.
How much is it? How much is it?
That much?
Incredible, huh?
You can say that again.
This must be the paper they used to negotiate Max's salary.
The ringmaster signed and dated it.
What's the matter, Nick?
Max definitely got a raise. But this document is dated a week ago.
Ringmaster's paper is added to the record.
I think that's all of notice in here. So we're gonna move on.
I'll try going back to the lodge. Oh wait.
Nope, nothing yet. That's odd. Okay. There should be another area I need to open up, actually.
Sorry, I don't really exactly remember what I'm supposed to do here.
Present some of the new stuff to her.
No, that didn't do it.
Maybe I talk to her about Max.
Max now, anyways.
You don't know?
Nope.
He's been arrested. He was charged with the murder of your father.
It's okay. Nick and I will help him.
Max isn't the guy, is he? I mean, the criminal?
Of course he's not.
I'm worried about so many things right now.
Like what?
That was it. We opened up a topic. What's on your mind?
Regina, what's the matter? What's on your mind?
I'll tell you, Maya, but just you.
It was about this and that and this and...
What, really?
And then this happened and that happened and... Oh, it was awesome.
Oh my, that's incredible, Regina.
Come on, Nick. There's no reason to pout.
Don't worry about me.
Regina told me that someone professed their love to her.
Professed their love?
Not only that, it was Maximilian Galactica.
I wonder how many people have stolen one of his hearts anyway.
And then on the exact same day, another person professor love for her as well.
What? Who was it?
Someone named Trilo.
Trilo?
Apparently he is a tenor who sings in the circus.
I haven't met him yet.
And Regina seems to be quite the hit with the men in the circus.
She must have some sort of strange power over them.
You're not kidding. Two people in one day? Even I want to profess my love for her.
Me too. She's so cute.
Okay, well now we can't find out about Freelo yet.
That's probably all I can get out of her at the moment, I think.
Yes, there we go. Perry's big circus entrance.
Huh? Hey, Nick, look over there.
What?
There's someone over there. Excuse me.
Hello.
Wow, he sure is a quiet one. Excuse me!
What? Me? Yes, you work at the circus, don't you?
No, I'm just your average Joe.
An average Joe who just happens to hang out at the circus? I don't think so.
Yes, I am. I've got nothing to do with what's going on here.
He's lying, like any regular person would hang around the circus, just like that.
I'm an attorney. My name is Phoenix Wright.
I'm a spirit medium. My name is Maya.
Well, I, just happen to be, passing by.
I don't suppose you happen to be some kind of carny.
Not a carny. I'm a performer, actually. I'm a ventriloquist.
Ventriloquist?
I'm Benjamin. Woodman.
Your last name is Woodman?
Yes, that's right. But everyone calls me Ben.
Yes. That's your alias, right?
I believe they call it a stage name.
We can try, but he won't say much right now. What happened?
Excuse me, Ben.
Yes, you mean me?
About the murder, I'd like to talk to you about the details, if I may.
Really, I'm just a regular, normal guy.
I don't know.
This guy is so nervous, he's creeping me out.
Nick, cheer up. Just try and smile.
Max Galactica.
Would you mind telling us something about Max?
Maximilian Galactica?
Max?
He's not nice.
Did he just say that Max is not very nice?
My head hurts.
Yikes, I hope he's okay.
It sounds like he just popped a gasket.
Ventriloquism.
Ben, so you're a ventriloquist?
I'm a just a regular good guy.
You already told us that you were a ventriloquist.
Oh, yes.
Nick, don't yell at him. You can't do that.
I can't help it. He's making me nervous.
Ben, do you mind showing me some of your skills as a ventriloquist?
Right. And then
he's contagious.
Yeah, like I said, he won't tell me much right now.
I go back and ask Regina about him?
That guy, his name is Ben, right?
You don't know him?
I don't know, he didn't really catch my eye. He's from this tree though, right?
Wait. We're the ones asking the questions around here.
Alright, well, we'll just keep moving forward then.
Can't really do much there right now. Let's go to the lodging area. Try Mo again. There we go.
Lodging hall, first floor, Mo's room.
Hello, Mo! Congratulations, you're the big winner! Gina, the 1 millionth visitor to the room of one Mr. Mo Pearls, aka me!
Earplugs, must find earplugs.
To celebrate this momentous occasion, will you care for an organic grape? Just one! You got my joke right there! I welch on giving you more than one!
No,
if it was funny, it is your duty as a human being to laugh! People who don't laugh are usually less seen in... Let's sing! Catch my drift!
Maya? This is like some... Faustian nightmare.
Come on, it was funny! Clowns are always funny on my book.
In my book, they're just funny looking.
You sure do have great taste in clothes, girly. Look at that garb! You look just like Greta Garb. Whoa!
I'm going home.
No, Nick, you can't!
You know I can excuse a bad joke or two, but... This stooge keeps laughing at his own jokes. That's what I object to.
Okay, I get it. But you have to admit, he is kind of funny.
No, I do not have to admit that because he isn't.
I don't like talking to him.
Very big circus.
Could you please tell us more about the very big circus?
It's a very big story. Are you sure you got that kind of time?
Then the bite just keeps coming.
The circus has been in business for 20 years. We all performed under the guidance of the ringmaster, Russell Berry.
20 years? Wow.
Working in the circus is never easy, especially nowadays. With movies, TV, and bowling, there is just too much competition.
But, I love the circus.
I love it too. That is why I've been here for 20 years. They work hard to keep the show running. No one's sent in the clowns to on us.
Nick, he just made a joke. Laugh.
Har.
The ringmaster was a real big shot in the circus world, a real class act. Even when there were no customers, Russell would use his own money to pay me. Because he knew that I had a family to care for. He was happy to take care of his employees.
I see.
How could anyone do that to such a wonderful man?
A mad clown, oh joy.
Mo?
Wiggity, what? I'm
sorry, Mo. Nick was born without a sense of humor.
Don't worry about it.
How can you fault someone for being born that way?
Let's talk about the murder, shall we?
Let's see. It must have taken place around 10 p.m. last night. After rehearsals were finished, I was tuckered out, so I came back here. After I went to bed, that's when I caught a peek of it.
Caught a peek?
Of the crime!
So this is what Detective Gumshoe was talking about. Mo was the witness, the eyewitness to the crime.
Ask about Russell Berry.
The Ringmaster was truly ahead of his time. He would always add new elements to the show.
New elements?
When you've been a performer for a long time, your act starts getting a bit stale.
I realize that even my act can get a bit long in the tooth.
Sometimes my jokes can be a bit, old-fashioned.
A bit long in the tooth.
But that make-believer takes things too far.
Make-believer?
The magician, the one that thinks he's all high and mighty. He had the gall to say to me, "You're one of those funny types, right?" What does he mean, one of those... the joke's on him now.
On him?
Yep, he got on everyone's nerves. The day of the murder...
Go ahead.
No, no way! Just forget I said anything.
I bet he's still hiding something about Max.
What you witnessed.
You say you saw the crime. Do you mind telling me what you saw?
Well, the police told me that I can't share my story with others.
Don't say a word.
I'm just gonna have to let these lips stay zipped.
That's not fair.
I guess you're right. Maybe I can tell you a few details.
But only if you can get old Stiff Lips here to make what's so funny.
Stiff Lips?
Wait, do you mean me?
Nick, you can do it. Come on.
What's the matter?
Just getting ready, okay. Do you know why I, Phoenix Wright, am a great lawyer?
Because I'm right all the time.
At least his expectations are low.
I wouldn't let him quit his day job.
Sheesh. Cut a guy some slack.
At least it was funnier than Chuckles over here.
It wasn't the greatest joke I've heard, but you did try, so I'll tell you what I saw.
I'm sorry he's incapable of being funny, Mo.
That night, once I had tucked myself into bed, I heard this amazing noise. It was incredibly loud. It sounded like a giant thump. Once I heard it, I jumped out of bed. That's when I saw it.
Without question, without a doubt, it was that magician.
That's all I saw, but it just proves how terrible that man actually is.
He knows more about Max than he's letting on.
Present anything? Let's try asking about Max, actually.
He thinks he can kill the Ringmaster, it's only just that he should die too.
Mo?
Sorry, I crossed the line, but He truly is a disgusting human being. Why do you hate him so much? Let me tell you this one story. The morning before the murder, something terrible happened. Max clocked Ben right over the head as hard as he could. Ben, ventriloquist with the speech impediment? You should go to the cafeteria and investigate for yourselves. The cafeteria? Let's just say there's gotta be something interesting there. Yes. The very big circus is very big, isn't it? You should always carry a map with you to get around. Thank you. This is an atlas. I kill myself, really? I'm dying here. Corner! Now he's just laughing to hear his own voice. Circus map added in the record. Okay, now we can leave. Finally. Phew! Let's go to the cafeteria. It's by the big top. There we go. Cafeteria. Big top cafeteria. Phew! This place is gross! This must be because of last night. I didn't have time to clean up after dinner because of the murder. That reminds me, what was it that Mo said? He said that yesterday morning Max clunked Ben over the head here. He also said that there's gotta be something interesting there? Nick, what's gotta be interesting? Don't ask. Okay, examining time. Start with this. Or not. There's something there. There we go. That's what I was trying to hit. What's this? Must be a juice bottle or something. Ah, watch out, Nick! Broken glass on the floor is dangerous. A broken bottle just lying in the middle of the floor? Do you think it means anything? There's gotta be something interesting there. Huh? Looks like we're going to have to go back and meet with him. Him? Looks like we're going to have to go back and meet with him. Him? Broken bottle added to the court record. That's all we're going to do here. Moving on to go meet with, well, whoever he is. Center's visitor's room. Oh, it's my two sweeties. Welcome to the detention center. Did he just call me his sweetie again? What's on today's agenda? What can I help you with? Well, we've gathered quite a few clues. Wonderfully fantabulous. Fabulous. That's why we came to meet with you again. What's wrong? Quit making such a scary face. Okay then, Max, let's make this absolutely fabulous. Set a clock, anyone? Oops, wrong button. Thank you.
There we go. It's free Cyclops. Meeting with Russell. Last night you met with the ringmaster, correct? To negotiate your salary and such. Exactly! We reached an agreement about the salary from my 6-month-old contract. That's the truth, the whole truth, and nothing but the truth? What do you mean? You just went to his office to negotiate your new salary. I hate lies, and I hate liars even more! What are you insinuating? Do you have any proof that I did something other than negotiate my new fee last night? Try this on for size. Documents relating to Max's salary negotiations. He got an enormous raise 1 week ago. That it was on the table in the ringmaster's room. You weren't lying when you said that you received quite a raise. Is there a problem with being well compensated? Not with the compensation, just with the date. This is dated 1 week ago. Max, you finished your contract negotiations 1 week ago. Fabulous. One down. Alright, I'll tell you the truth. That night, the ringmaster called me to his room. He called you? Why did he do that? Sorry, sweetie, that's private. The ringmaster called him. I wonder if there was some sort of problem. Max, perhaps you could share with me what you two spoke about. Well, not if I don't have to. Isn't this why the ringmaster called you into his room that night? The bottle. Isn't this why you were called to the ringmaster's room that night? Where did you get that? The cafeteria. But you already knew that, didn't you? Of course. Two down. It fell and broke on the floor. He's still hiding something else. Max? What is it, my sweetie? It didn't fall and break on the floor. You used this bottle, too. Get that little loser pen. Take that! The pen? You nailed him over the head with this bottle, didn't you? And that's why you got called to the ringmaster's room that night. Fabulous! You might as well be a magician! Unlock successful. The truth is, yesterday morning during breakfast we had a run-in. You mean you had a fight with Ben, the ventriloquist? You could put it that way. I mean, why did you fight with him? Ben seems like such a quiet man. We fought about my sweetie pie. You mean Regina? That ill-bred creep told my sweetie pie princess that he was in love with her. Would you put up with that? Ill-bred? Are you talking about the same Ben? Told her he was in love with her? Are you sure this is Ben we're talking about? All I can say is that he made me mad and I had to tap him on his hard head. That's when the ringmaster called me and I realized that it was my chance. Your chance? That's when I went to his room and I laid it all out on the table. I asked him to let me marry my sweetie pie. What? Excuse me. The ringmaster told me that it sounds good to me. That
why my sweetie pie is my sweetie pie. And no one else's.
I see.
Since Ben was causing me so much trouble, I realized I had to shut him up.
Shut him up?
Shut him up. What do you mean by shut him up?
You don't know, do you, my sweeties? Unless Ben and Trilo are together, Trilo can't say a word.
Trilo?
The puppet, the ventriloquist puppet, his real name is Triloquist.
But a puppet doesn't talk.
I know, that's why I hid it.
Before the police came and took me away, of course.
If that puppet started flopping off at the balls, I'd be screwed.
You hid him? You mean the ventriloquist puppet?
You are so smart, sweetie.
Where did you hide him?
What, sweetie? You weren't thinking of trying to add him to my defense, are you?
Well, Ben does seem, like, awfully lonely without his puppet.
Fabulous! That should have taught him a lesson. Okay, I hit Trilo in the ringmaster's room. You don't mind going there and getting Trilo for me, do you, my sweetie?
No problem. None at all. Thank you, Max.
You know I can't stand to see my sweeties in a jam.
Then don't go hiding puppets. We heard a lot about you at the circus, Max.
You must mean from the dinosaurs. How were those Jurassic... Jurassic...
Max, you aren't very popular with the other performers, are you?
Yes, 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 sweetie, that's what they call jealousy. Jealousy. They're absolutely jealous of my absolutely fabulous self. People who really understand can see the obvious differences between us.
People who really understand?
For instance, my sweetie pie.
So Regina understands him, huh?
I plan on getting married to her. She is truly my sweetie pie princess.
Wow, that's so cool.
It is already in the works.
You met with the ringmaster on the night of the murder.
Yes, it was with him around 10 p.m. once I was done with practice.
I went to his room right after we finished. They found the ringmaster's body in the plaza in front of the lodging house.
Yes, I heard about that.
It should be heard, not head. They're missing an R. Like pointing out spelling mistakes.
He needed to step out for a bit, so I waited in his room for him to return.
Huh?
Sorry, Max. I have something I must attend to right now.
Do you mind waiting for me right here?
It's pretty cold outside. Where's your coat?
It's alright. I'll be right back. It should only take about 10 minutes.
And then? I waited for him. But he never came back.
Did he go to the plaza where the body was discovered?
Possibly. The snow had tapered off a bit, but it was still very cold outside. But I have no idea what he went off to do.
Well, we'll be heading off ourselves. We need to go see Ventriloquist.
Circus entrance.
Huh? Ben's not here anymore.
Yeah, I wanted to ask him something.
It's cold out. He's probably in the tent.
Let's go find the dummy for him. Circus Big Top.
What do you think, Nick? I wonder if we've been making any progress.
Well, yeah, we have to be, or we wouldn't be this far in the game.
Don't be so negative. Of course we're making progress. But everyone loved the Ringmaster, and there's no sign of footprints on the scene. There's still a lot of mysteries left to be solved.
Of course.
Now Regina isn't here either. Not seeing how that's related.
Ringmaster's room.
It looks the same as always, a great big mess. Considering how messy it is, I bet they wouldn't notice if another poster went missing.
Will you just stop it, you poster pilfer?
I'm just kidding. You know I already got one of those posters.
You mean stole one of those posters?
Yeah, let's focus on what Max told us. He said that he hid Trilo somewhere in this room.
Trilo.
Oh, the ventriloquist puppet, right.
The puppet's in the trophy area over here.
Nick, look at all the cute trophies.
Indeed, just look at all the rewards the circus has won.
Like, all county quiz champions, Ringmaster's Association, Mini Golf Master, Beer Belly Balloon Pounce Champ, Pet Grooming Grand Prix. Wow, the Ringmaster was multi-talented in ways I could have never imagined.
There's something shoved under the bookshelf.
This is... That's Trilo! That's Ben's puppet.
I think you're right. We'll give it back to him later.
Trilo quest handed to Maya. Why do I have to carry that thing?
Because I don't want to carry the dummy.
Now, I believe that he's in the cafeteria.
Well, something's happening anyway.
Oh, hey, Ben.
Hello.
Hello to you, too. It's awfully cold today, don't you agree?
I do indeed.
Don't you think it's cold, Nick?
I don't see how talking about the weather is helping our case.
Talking won't do anything until we give him the puppet. So let's just cut to the chase.
Ben, this is yours, isn't it?
Yes, that's mine.
Here you go.
Cue the quiz return to Ben.
Alright, Maya, let's get going.
It's that time. It's that time, isn't it? See you around, Ben.
Okay.
So, Nick, where are we going next?
Let's see. Maybe we should go talk to...
Hey, wait! Who said that? What are you looking at? I'm right here, you blind wench.
Hey, don't call me blind. Just because I'm blind doesn't mean I have to say it.
What's your problem anyways? Don't you know how to properly greet someone?
Ben? Is that you, Ben?
No! I would never... It was me! Yeah, me! Down here!
You're Trilo.
That is Mr. Quista, you pisser. Learn some manners before you just blurt out my name. Now try speaking to me again, but this time with some proper respect.
Not again.
Mr. Quist, is that better? No, look at me when I am talking to you. You 8-bit excuse for an attorney.
Trilo, we talked about insulting people. You promised.
But he was mocking me. Being mean to bullies was not included in that deal.
I'm sorry, Trilo.
No. what just happened? Trail's still a puppet, but... Hey, who do you think you're calling a puppet?
You, but we'll talk to you anyway.
Tell us what you know about the murder.
Are you talking at me? I say, you talking at me? Don't look at him when you're talking at me.
Trailer Quiz, you behave, young man.
Shut up, Woody. What murder are you talking about? You mean the one where they offed the old man?
I guess so.
No need to make such a fuss about things. That old mutt paid us all peanuts.
Trailer, you can't say things like that. I didn't raise you to be that kind of puppet.
Don't you have nerve pills or something to take right now?
These two are really an odd couple, aren't they, Nick?
Okay, I'll talk. Gramps got it. Clobbered over the head. Let me ladle that for you. The pace sucks, the clown sucks, and my partner has his hand up my pants.
Your partner? You mean Ben?
Yeah, the creepy old guy who never finds it in himself to leave me alone. Tell him to back off for me, will ya? He's just another one of the dorks around here.
Oh my!
But I'll be fair. In this cesspool of human garbage masquerading as circus performers, I found my Madonna!
Your...
Madonna?
Regina! My lovely Regina! She is stunning, right, Ben?
Well, I'm not sure if I would go that far.
You'll have to excuse him. He does not understand what he speaks. I, on the other hand, am an appreciator of true beauty, hence why I shall marry her.
Marry?
Oh, dear. Flying fraud.
The ringmaster got knocked upside his cheap head by that flying fraud.
You mean Max Galactica?
Why do you say that?
Trilo, straighten up. Don't accuse people like that.
Straighten up? I'm made of wood. Besides, you weren't there. You know what happened.
You were there?
If you're that interested, then I'll let you in on the facts.
Marriage.
You're going to marry Regina?
That's right.
She doesn't quite realize the joy that awaits her, does she?
But she did seem a bit worried about things.
Well, she... I don't care. It is my choice, not hers. We're getting hitched.
I know you think that, but...
But what?
But what? I gave her a special gift. I gave her the wonderful gift of song.
You gave her a song?
Well, I am a renowned tenor. You'll be happy to know that I've decided to grace you with one of my songs.
Me. I want you to touch me, I want you to kiss me, I want you to...
The rest is private.
Well, the melody is pretty good.
But those lyrics, I think they need a little work.
Who asked you?
I'm the artist here.
Thanks.
Now that Trilo's here, does that mean you can talk normally now?
Hey, butt face! must be looking forward to tomorrow, aren't you, Mr. Ambulance Chaser? You know, it's time to get rid of that pesky magician once and for all. Trillo? Enough jibba-jabba. Let's get to court already. Hey, wait a second. Nick, what's going on? He's a witness for tomorrow's trial. Good going there, Phoenix. Good going, Phoenix. The big top. What in the world happened with Ben and Trillo? Quite a pair of those two. Ugh. Oh no. Now what? It's a monkey. What is it, Nick? The monkey. My badge. The monkey stole it. What? Mr. Attorney, that face was so cute. You look so completely dumbfounded. Regina. You, that monkey. Hey, no need to get angry. But my attorney's badge. Don't worry, I'll help you out. Okay, if you say so. If I don't get my badge back, how can I flash it? By the way, the monkey's name is... Money Money the Monkey. His name is... Money? Money the Monkey. The monkey, it's called Money? Yes. Well, the rich ape just stole my attorney's badge. Mind if I get that back? I'll see what I can do. Even I have money problems. Eh? Whenever Money sees something shiny, he takes it back home. That's pretty funny. Well, I guess I'll just have to find out where Money disappeared to. I think that's your best bet. You should probably ask Uncle Mo. He must know. Huh? You don't know? Well, Money isn't exactly someone I'm on friendly terms with. What? He's not really the kind of animal I work with, even if he does need taming. Oh, I see. Go to Mo's. I guess it is time that I revisit that kooky clown. Go visit Mo's. What is this, The Simpsons? Ben and Trillo. Do you mind telling us a bit about Ben? Ben? You mean the guy that is always hanging around with Trillo? What do you mean, hanging around? Well, he was there when Trillo told me that he was in love with me. Trillo told you he was in love with you? Yes, he did. Kinda cute, don't you think? He's so smart and he's such a wonderful singer. I love him. But what about Ben? What about Ben? He's got nothing to do with me loving Trillo. Like sand through the hourglass. So are the days of the circus. Proposal. Regina, you were proposed to, weren't you? Proposed to? Nope. That won't be for a while. Huh? Really? That's strange, isn't it, Nick? Yeah, Max and Trillo both said otherwise. They said they asked for her hand in marriage. But Max only talked to the ringmaster about it. I forgot about that. He asked the ringmaster for her hand, not Regina directly. So I guess Trillo hasn't asked her directly yet.
What? He's going to propose to me? I'm so confused. How about you, Maya? Huh? What? Who do you think I should go for, Max or Trilo? Wait, what? You do realize that Trilo is a puppet. I don't care that he's a bit stiff. Oh boy. Well, let's go, visit Mo, like they told us to do. Lodging House Plaza. Detective Gumtree took off already? Yep, just leave him alone for a while, okay, Maya? I'm sure he just got lonely and headed back to the precinct. Back to Mo's room. Oh my, if it isn't Mr. Right all the time! It's alright to be wrong every now and again, right? See, Nick, it just took a while for the joke to find its audience. So what can I do for you? Did you remember a good joke you wanted to tell me? Pull up a chair, or maybe just pull my finger and let me have it. We're going to get this same sound effect either way, aren't we? How'd you know? I put a whoopee cushion on the chair. You really know what it takes to be a clown, don't you? Just let us talk, please. So, about Regina. Regina is such a pure, innocent child. She's such a cutie, too. She was born and raised in the circus, you know. But that means she doesn't really know much about the world outside the Big Top. Sounds like Pearlie. For her, every child's dream of the circus is her everyday reality. She lives in a dream world? Every day she sees dancing wild animals, men flying in the air, and one very funny clown. The funny thing is, that all seems normal to her because it is her everyday life. I guess that explains why she thinks she can marry a ventriloquist puppet. Don't ask me if her reality is a good thing or a bad thing, though. A clown sees life simply without complications. Money the Monkey. Have you ever heard of a monkey named Money? Ah, yes, Money! He stole my attorney's badge. Well, Money does love shiny objects. It makes sense that he'd swipe your badge. But under no circumstances can you chase after him. Why is that? Oh, I know. You don't want to get involved in any monkey business, right? Exactly! Bravo, bravo! Enough joking around, though. Money isn't considered a member of Regina's family. Then why does he belong? Who does he belong to? I'll be happy to take you to where his owner's staying. You mean right now? Of course! Shall we go? Should we go with him now or wait a while? Go with Mel. December 28th, Lodging House, 3rd floor, Acro's room. This is it! What's wrong, Mr. Wright? I can't breathe. Don't be such a wimp! You only had to climb 2 flights of stairs! Anyways, this is the place, Acro's room. Acro? He's an acrobat. It seems like he's not around today. That's a big pile of junk over there in the corner. I I don't think it'd be wrong to assume that Phoenix's stuff is over there, too. Just be careful to make sure you've got the right stuff. Thanks, Mo. See you later. Money has been added to the court record. Let's get our badge. Whew. I guess it's over in this pile? Holy cow! There's a fork and a mirror? Everything's shiny! There's even a really cheap-looking knockoff wristwatch. Look at this. It's a trophy. And it's really heavy. Nick, I found it! Your badge! It's right here! Phoenix's attorney's badge has been returned. Thanks. You really saved me, huh? What's the matter? Did you find something? Yeah, check this out. It's a ring! There's something engraved on it. From T to R. Ring put in pocket. Guess that's it for now. Well, I think it's about time we wrap up our investigation. Do you think we'll win in court tomorrow? Who knows? Even I can't imagine what kind of testimony will come out tomorrow. I'm guessing Mo will be a witness in court tomorrow. Mo and maybe the puppet. Don't worry, Nick. No matter what, we've still got a magician on our side. That's good. Because we might need some magic tomorrow. To be continued, guys. That's it for the first part of the game, the investigation phase. I'm your host, Kaylee Hutari. Please like, subscribe, comment, let me know what you think, if you have any comments, any questions. And next time, we will go on with the trial. Until then.